I don't like when you start it like that. It's so unorganic. What is going on, Dank Fam? It is your boy Mike Diesel, and today I'm finally revealing my 2019 ZX6R stunt build. I went ahead and flipped a stoppy, trying to avoid an accident, and ended up breaking a couple things like the subframe, the mounts for the exhaust, and a couple odds and ends. So lo and behold, we finally have everything done on the bike for the most part. A couple odds and ends still to do, but as far as all the main functions, we now have a 2019 stunt bike. Rather than ride it for a couple weeks, get it all clapped out, and break all the fairings and everything else, I have not even rode this bike yet, popped a wheelie on it or anything like that, and I literally just finished it up this morning. Today we're gonna be breaking down all the parts on this bike as far as everything that I've used to build it. I'll have the links in the description if you guys are building a 2019 as well, if you wanna put these parts on. And basically just kinda going through everything and I'm explaining as far as all the parts that I put on it and the reason behind them. So the first part that we went ahead and replaced was one of the main things that I broke in the accident, which was the 8-ounce custom subframe. One of the things with the 2009 ZX6Rs and up is that the stock subframe is super weak. They have two halves. It'll be an aluminum half and then a cast aluminum half. So I guarantee if you flip a wheel, you're gonna break that subframe. So if you're doing some serious stunt riding, definitely recommend checking out 8-ounce customs. This thing is super smooth, people. I'm not trying to be a salesman right now, but like the only thing I had to trim was right here. And you still have an option for your taillight, which is super nice because a lot of brands don't have the option to run a taillight for the subframe. And the fact that I can still run the subframe, this thing looks like a clean street bike from the rear end, is super nice. As everything runs inside of the battery tray as it's supposed to, the battery and the ECU and everything else. So you don't have to hack up anything. There is one little trick with your front seat. Give a little. Another big thing that I upgraded was the front fairing stay. And this is also 8-ounce customs. And this thing as well is super easy to install. Lots of good protection. Holds everything nice. It even gives you a little outline to cut your windscreen. And then the last part that I got from 8-ounce customs was this cage. This is a cage that I switched to for my 0304 ZX6R. And it's really nice. The clearance on it and everything else. She's good. Even if you're fully about to roll over, the bars aren't hitting, it's nice. So we're moving on from all the 8-ounce custom parts. Just to reiterate, subframe, fairing stay, and cage, all 8-ounce customs. And one thing I will say about their parts, for being a newer gen bike, this was such an easy bike to build. Like not just 8-ounce customs, but all the other brands that I put on. But as far as like building a stunt bike, this is by far the simplest and easiest bike that I've ever built. So a huge shout out to Tank Tanks on this. This is a guy over in Texas that sponsors my bikes for the gas tanks. So basically this is a stock gas tank, and then my man Tang cuts the lip off, puts the new shaped metal on, builds me a nice new lip, and then reinforces it in certain spots. My particular lip is the Dank lip, and he pushes the lip back really far, makes it nice and low so it's not chopping you in the gut. And then one other thing that I ask him to do is reinforce the tabs for the gas tank hinge in the rear so they don't bend out or anything like that. But so far, putting my legs on it and everything else, I'm super comfy with, flexibility is gonna be a little tricky with full fairings, but it's got potential, you know? What do you think?
I think it's mint.
You think I'm lanky?
Yeah, you're lanky as fuck.
Dick, dude. I can see it in your eyes. You're filming, but I can see you're like, this dude is not moving around like that when he gets on his bike. You know, it's okay to be short sometimes. You can move around the tank like a monkey. All right, getting back to it. Brake lines. Brake lines are super important. Don't build a stunt bike and not get steel braided brake lines. It's a cheap upgrade for the amount of performance that you get out of it. And I will always be rocking that Moto Store core braided lines. So core is the braided lines, and I get all my brake lines from the Moto Store. They are super nice with the shipping and customer service, everything else. They're based out of Texas. I love Moto Store, I love core. Translucent green brake lines with the green fittings, and that's from your boy core. Oh, and by the way, the brake lines are from core.
Core brake lines.
A Magura 16 millimeter handbrake master, also from the Moto Store. These Brembo reservoirs, also from the Moto Store. Budget ran low, stimulus check didn't come, so we went with the stock triple tree. Shout outs to the Sick Shop, another big supporter on this build. Got all my parts on time, didn't sponsor anything on the build, just simply great customer service with ordering parts. These beautiful clip-ons are the RSC fully adjustable clip-ons with the 7-degree bend. So this color green is the new color green that he's offering for 2020. That's one big experimental thing that I haven't used in a while is clip-ons. These things are one of my own products available on dankwheelie.com. We got the 2009 through 2020-21 ZX6R block off plates, clean and simple. The headlight, I had a custom ordered hand dipped in green iguana skin front headlight install. You can actually see the scaling from the iguana. Can you kind of see that?
Yeah.
If you're gonna do this, make sure you have a reptile tamer that's been around for about 3 different years. And the reptile tamer, he's gonna have to have this iguana very mature right before mating time, but not after mating time. You wanna get this iguana so the skin's nice and intact and it's gonna be able to lay out on this headlight super, super clean. If you guys have any questions about the iguana skin headlight wrap, don't ask me because I just made that up. Stunt Pucks for the axle sliders. Big shout outs to them. They wanted to sponsor the giveaway bike with a set. So I asked him if he could send me a set for the 19 to try out, and he did. And these are really nice because they're all Delrin. Really super easy to install. And we'll give them a shot and see how well they do. But just adds a little bit more protection to your bike when it falls over. Rear sets, I'm running NDC rear sets with the shorty pegs. They make long pegs and they make short pegs. My preference, I like short pegs. The cool thing about them is they mount right up, work really well, and you don't have a brake light. That's not a plus. We're taking bets right now. How long do you guys think this acropovic pipe's gonna stay intact?
One session.
One session?
Intact? It'll stay intact for a long time.
Like minty, like that?
Like first scratch, first session. Bet, dude. Guaranteed.
Hope he's wrong, people. The other part that I got off RSC was the fully adjustable sub cage. This thing is so nice, people. This is like my favorite part in all my bikes. It's just such a sturdy, diesel, beautiful looking part. So the battery tray on the ZX6R is different for this gen versus the previous gen, meaning that the sub cage would require different plates. What I did was I used the previous gen sub cage plates, I put the top bolts in, and then I used a heat gun to heat up the battery tray, and once the plastic was pliable, I pulled up on the sub cage to get it into place and threaded the bolts in. In the future, RSC is gonna be dropping a special 2019 sub cage plate. I'm just impatient and I wanted it on ASAP. So one of the last main bread and butters for this bike is gonna be the handbrake bracket that I designed. So the reason I designed my own handbrake bracket is that way I could still run the 310 rotor that I wanted, as well as have my Brembo right here and my four piston caliper for my handbrake. This is a bracket that I designed with Manic Machining. They're gonna be for sale. We're just fine tuning some things right now, but I love this thing now that we finally finished up the swing arm apps axle block. So this axle block actually holds your bracket in place if you're to take your wheel off to change it out. But it's also great for these swing arms since they're super brittle for these newer gen bikes. And it gives it a lot more support if you're doing shuffles and stuff like that, and hopefully not destroying your swing arm. I'm not saying this is gonna prevent destroying your swing arm, but it definitely helps out. Another added bonus, if I had an 0304, I could just take this little insert right here and slide this bracket on my 0304 and it'll work on that bike as well. So it's a really universal bracket. So if you guys want one of these brackets, they're gonna be for sale soon. Bother Manic Machining.
I've heard people say.
Oh, hey. Heard you were looking for the party. Well, here she is, people. You can't have a stunt bike. Well, you can, but it's not as fun without a big old sprocket in the rear. So we went with a 60 tooth rear sprocket, kept the same pitch of 520 as stock, and then we went ahead and hooked it up with this fat old, sorry, I can't remember the specific term of this. It's just a really nice chain. So we went with the 3D Vortex 520 chain. I think I got 150 links, didn't need all them. But that's wrapped around this beautiful 60 tooth Vortex sprocket. It's aluminum, so we're gonna test it out to see how well she lasts as far as beating on it. But I've never had a Vortex stunt sprocket before, so I'm pretty excited to try it out. We're gonna give her a shot. But big thank you to Vortex for sponsoring this build and also sponsoring the giveaway that I'll be having for you guys very soon. So stay tuned, check out Vortex if you guys need a stunt sprocket. Eat! This is HT Moto seat cover. That's right. You order a HT Moto C cover from the Six Shop, bust out your staple gun, and put it on yourself. You save a lot more money and time waiting on your seat to get back.
So what do you have inside the bike though?
Don't worry about it. You wanna know what's inside, don't you? There's two things with these newer gen ZX6Rs that you wanna keep in mind. Most importantly, always keep your bike cool. So number one is obviously keeping it protected, having your cages and everything else and your subframe. We went through all the parts that we have on this to keep it protected. But the second And arguably the most important is keeping your bike cool. When you're doing burnouts and slow speed stunts and everything else, this thing is trying its best to overheat, and it's guaranteed to do so if you don't do a couple things. So we're gonna bust down the inside of this thing and show you what's under the hood. So this is a Damage Control Parts radiator cage with two R6 fans. And this is more than twice the amount of power that you have versus your normal stock system when it comes to cooling your bike down. Since the ECU is flashed by Jason Britton, that means that this fan's gonna kick on at 150 versus 185 or 215, which is stock. But one thing you wanna do if you're doing that flash is take this clutch right here. This little sensor right here is what usually plugs in your clutch. You need to cut that sensor off, twist those wires together, and ground them out. So as far as under the hood, flash the ECU, twist the clutch sensor, Damage Control Parts radiator cage, and two R6 fans. And also, when you're installing the R6 fans versus the one stock fan, take the stock Kawasaki fan, cut the plug off, wire in the two R6 fans into the stock plug, and plug it right into the harness. Because when you flash the ECU, it's gonna go ahead and turn the fans on automatically whenever your bike hits 150 degrees or higher. And then last, but not least, the most important thing is the clean air mod, people. So what, you can do 10-mile-long wheelies, but if you do one of them on this thing, it's guaranteed to blow up. So the clean air mod basically seals up your airbox, makes sure no oil's leaking into it after extended long duration wheelie. Clean air mod, DCP radiator cage with dual R6 fans, ECU flash, twist the clutch together, good to go. Alrighty guys, so I just wanted to give you a quick walk around of the bike, which didn't end up being too quick, but that's it, people. That's all there is to my 2019 ZX6R. I want all you guys to be informed as far as how I built this bike, in case you guys are building it yourself or if you're just curious. But big shout out to my boy John Bueller, aka Cowie Stunts. He helped me out with this bike tremendously. I didn't really pick up too many wrenches doing this whole build since I've been injured, but this was a really fun project that me and him did while I was healing with my shoulder and everything else. Yeah, it turned out really great. So once again, big thank you to Stunt Pucks, Vortex, and Righteous Stunt Metal for sponsoring all the parts on this bike. I think she's gonna do pretty good. Let me know what you guys think about it. And other than that, yeah, feel free to like, comment, subscribe. And like always, keep it dank. Later.